on the set of our new video, Drowning, being directed by the Malloys.
The Malloys, really good directors. If they just want a VMA.
We've done videos for the Foo Fighters, Blink-182, 311, The Used, Inland Empire, and now Crazy Town.
Everything is so complex. Every day is like a test, full of obstacles that seem almost impossible.
And I'm thinking, just another breath, not a minute left. How long have I been drifting?
Pass the glass pipe, get the flashlight, now break it. People say I'm a star, but I still think I'll never make it.
It was kind of inspired by the movie The Outsiders. We follow this one young kid who's like the little brother of all these guys. He goes up and finds a girl, and they go up and hang out, and they're just innocently hanging out. The jock guys roll up on the kid and start hassling them and beat him up. The kid comes down all beat up to his buddies and tells them what happens, and they go driving around looking for the guys. He's caught in the middle of something that he wanted no part of, and he's drowning in his emotions.
We couldn't hear him say cut, so we kept going and shit, and it was just all crazy. I haven't been beat up, well, since ever. Yeah, so it's fun.
Sometimes I hate that chaos surrounds me. When all the answers that I see go around me. Am I drowning? Am I fading away? Or am I living up to all your dreams that made me this way? Am I drowning? Am I drowning? Am I drowning? Am I drowning?
The song has a real moody tone to it, and there's a lot of emotion in it.
Melodically, it's probably a big departure for a lot of people who may think that they know Crazy Town, but if you listen to the first album, Black Cloud is definitely a window into where we were going.
I've been to hell and back, looking for the answers to life, looking at myself, trying to get things right.
There's a lot of people who know us for the song Butterfly from our first record.
We wanted the success of Butterfly to die out a little bit.
While making this record, we had a lot of people whispering in our ear that you guys have a lot to prove to the world.
There's a lot more to the story that nobody knows.
We figured we were just supposed to be out there making great songs and great records, and with this record, we hope that everybody will get to see that that's exactly where our intentions were the whole time.
We toured, and we learned, and we worked out all the bugs, and we changed a couple members, and now Crazy Town is it's a force.
We're gonna make our own path, and we've always been that way.
If Crazy Town puts out a record, you know there's gonna be good songs on it, and you're gonna buy it to hear wherever whatever we did. It's a Crazy Town record. It's Crazy Town music. Period.
I wouldn't want to hear part two of the first record. You know, I want to be challenged as a fan and as a musician as well.
Climbing, I'll probably fall now that I think I won't fall, you know? When you say you aren't gonna do something, that's when it happens.
Yeah, I don't know about climbing up those ladders, bro.
I've never broken a bone. I'm about to.
Whatever, Seth's got the nuts, and Seth's got the nuts.
I used to climb shit like this all the time when I was little, but I'm old now.
This is our new drummer, Kyle. He was in a great band called Shovel that toured with us.
I've been really good friends with these guys for a while. We toured with them in my old band.
We would always be behind their set whenever they were playing, watching him play, because especially from behind, all you see is like these big, huge club arms. We were fortunate enough to have a guest appearance by Rivers Cuomo from Weezer on Hurt You So Bad.
I was sitting there and I was like, let's ask Rivers Cuomo from Weezer to do a guitar solo on this.
We sent him the song and he loved it, and we were grateful to have him come down and write an amazing part for it. It's a song that is very personal to all of us.
For the first time, Crazy Town feels like exactly the way it should be. I mean, there's nothing that needs to be changed. There's nothing I'm questioning. It's like we're a unit. As a team, the band really worked well together on this record, and everybody contributed and stepped up to the table and brought a lot of really great stuff.
We went away for a year and said, okay, we're going to make the kind of record that like I want to listen to 10 years from now, and put it out there and let everybody hear it, and that's all you could really ask for.